हेलो चिल्ड्रन, वेलकम बैक टू द लास्ट सेशन ऑफ द पोएम ऑन चिल्ड्रन। होप यू माइट हैव रेड दिस पोएम एंड अंडरस्टूड इट्स थीम। इन द पोएम यू हैव सम मोर डिफिकल्ट वर्ड्स। इन दिस ग्लॉसरी दे आर गिवन। द फर्स्ट वन इज लॉन्गिंग, means a strong desire. The second one is prophet, a foreseer or a spiritual teacher. Third one is dwell, to live. Fourth one is tarish, do not stay at one particular place. Fifth one is strive, make great efforts. Sixth one is gladness, means happiness. Seventh one is infinite, limitless. Eighth one is fourth, onwards in time. And the last one is stable, means firm. This picture signifies the relationship between parents and children. Though there are three metaphors. First one is the archer, one who is holding that bow with an arrow in his hand. He is that God Almighty. And the second one is the bow is parents. And the last one is the living arrows, refers to the children. When that archer, who is a great archer, and an archer who sees the distant future of your children and prompts them to shoot arrows at that goal in a very swift and correct direction, the more the bows bend, the arrow gets strength and it goes so fast in the correct direction, because that God Almighty, who is the creator of this universe and wants to see the children in their own future, because they have to act according to his direction, not according to your direction. The poem has weightage of 5 marks. One objective question will come from this poem and one long question of 4 marks. Totally you have 5 marks from this poem. In the next slide you have the summary of the poem. Just go through this summary. Khalil Gibran is a Lebanese American poet who brings out high philosophy of life in his simple and beautiful poetic essays. His well-known collection is called The Prophet. This poem, On Children, is a selection from that collection. On Children is a critique of the usual expectations of parents about their children. Through this poem, the poet offers to guide the parents on the essence of parenting with love, much against the mundane expectations. The same poem where a mother approaches the prophet to know about his perspectives on children, he captures the attention of his shocking declarations. Your children are not your children. He beautifully brings up the concept of life's creations and its aspirations, contrary to the accepted notions of parents. Making claims, the prophet says that they are just biologically means the children do not belong to you. Children leave their parents, but they do not belong to them. Parents may give them their love, but they should never force their ideas on children. Children have their own ideas and identity. The prophet says that parents have a biological bond is with the children now. However, the souls of the children lie in the future, which cannot be reached by the parents. So, the advice here is to parents is they shall not pressurize children with their thoughts. Parents are suggested rather to follow the ways of children than trying to change children to be like them. The prophet says that this is because life keeps moving forward and never retracts. He further substantiates his philosophy by making metaphorical references. Parents are compared to bows and arrows, and children are compared to the living arrows. The archer, who is that God Almighty himself, sets his eyes on the target, which is infinite, and he sends his arrows swift and far by bending the bow with his might. Parents should take delight in this act of bending that involves great strain. The prophet strikes perfect conclusion by referring to the law of creation, where God loves both the bow and the arrow as they complement each other on a life's infinite journey. The poet stresses here the importance of children's individual views and independent ideology, not influenced by their parents. This is the brief summary of the poem. Once again, go through this summary and read the poem twice and try to understand the summary of the poem and its theme. In the comprehension section, there are 7 objective questions. There are 7 objective questions in your comprehension section. The first one is, and a woman who held a babe against her bosom said, "Speak to us of children." And here he said, he refers to the prophet. B option is correct. The second one is, your children are not your children means. For this question, you have 3 options. C option is correct. Parents should not be possessive of their children. Third one is, they come through you but not from you means. Again, you have 3 options for this question. For this one, B option is correct. Fourth one is an important question. According to the prophet, what may be given to the children? Love is the correct answer. It is an important question. Fifth one is, their souls dwell in the house of tomorrow means. A option is correct. The children belong to their own future. And the sixth one is most likely objective question. The bows and living arrows refer to, there are 2 blank places. The bows refers to the parents. The living arrows refer to the children. And in the last objective question, there are 2 underlined words and phrases. They refer to what and whom. Arrow that flies means the children when they are launched for their better future. And the second one is the bow that is stable means when both are stable, the God loves both. And in second section, in second comprehension, you have 3 4 marks questions. questions. Write down these 4 marks questions in your fair book at your home. Thank you.